China's economy is grinding to a halt, making for uncertain times for many countries around the world, which are dependent on Chinese investments, tourists, and Chinese products. 15 to 20 years ago, China was already dubbed as the factory of the world. China already represents a third of the global trade. What we have seen now is that the supply chain and the sourcing has been interrupted. Singapore's economy, for example, is slipping into recession as Chinese tourist numbers drop by as much as 30%. Thailand's economy is also entering a recession, and Vietnam's manufacturing sector is fully dependent on a well-oiled supply chain from China. In January, their exports fell more than 17%. But some experts believe the threat extends well beyond this region, as all countries in the world depend on China's production. The West used to make over 80% of all its drugs domestically, back in the 90s. Now, only 20% is made domestically, while 80% is made in China. You see a problem here? The world is just too dependent on China. In other words, indeed, Europe and the US especially, these two clusters of economic activity, they were beholden to China, not to mention Asia. The global economy has been a bubble. The corona is just a needle that's popped the bubble. The bubble is called quantitative easing. The 20s will be known as the worst depression in history. Either save the people or save the economy. Right now, all countries trying to save the economy, which is a losing battle. The word pandemic really means crashed markets, and that is the long and the short of it. It is all about money and F the rest of us. The West knew that there were human rights violations in China, but the West thought of exploiting it with a blind eye. All bubbles will burst. All evil will end. And that's what history had taught us, but still, the blunder is repeated. When China falls, it will make others fall too. This is Corona Chaos. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. Please take some time to subscribe to my two backup channels. I do upload videos there, too, on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. Thank you. This was a squashing year for China. The trade war with the United States left its economy expanding at the slowest pace in 30 years. Economists estimate 4 million jobs may have been lost in 2019. This year is already being defined by the outbreak of the coronavirus, which has killed thousands and has infected thousands more, putting the brakes on China's economy. With much of the country in lockdown, the virus could affect up to 42% of China's economy, according to Standard Chartered. Companies may struggle to make payments on loans, leading to a rise in what is called non-performing loans of $1.1 trillion, according to Standard & Poor's. The Chinese airlines have been forced to ground planes and are expected to lose $12.8 billion in revenue. China's economy, which makes up 15.8% of the world's economy, is being slammed. Across China, businesses have their shutters down and doors locked as the coronavirus numbers soar. The economy has stalled. 2 months into this outbreak, travel restrictions and enforced quarantines are still preventing millions of people from returning to work. Businesses and factories in at least 24 provinces, municipalities, and other regions were told not to resume work until March 10 at the earliest. Together, these hubs account for more than 80% of China's GDP and 90% of its exports. At the same time, thousands of flights from more than 50 airlines were cancelled, as governments imposed travel restrictions to and from China. Domestic rail trips plummeted more than 75%, while its tourism industry is in a tailspin as the Chinese stay home and foreigners avoid the country. And it's not just the consumer landscape that has been severely disrupted. The fallout from the virus has essentially isolated the world's largest population from the rest of the world, disrupting worldwide trade and supply chains in the process. In the weeks following January 20, ship activity at China's major ports fell 20%. Even oil prices have fallen as demand weakens in China, the world's largest importer of crude oil. Automakers from Nissan to Honda and American giants Apple and Nike all have massive operations in China that have been impacted as well. China has also been the world's largest exporter for more than a decade, with many countries such as Japan and Vietnam very dependent on the Chinese supply chain. China is much more intertwined with the world economy than ever before. Because of this, the global economy, not just China, will feel the impact of the virus. Everything is made in China, even the virus, thanks to the greedy corporations. As the outbreak unexpectedly upended normal business operations across China, its overall impact on the economy is likely to be analyzed for decades to come. The first quarter of China's GDP is not gonna look good. Consumption, investment, export all are stagnated. This drag on for a few more months, and China and the world will be hit hard. The world heavily depends on the growth of China. The fallout would get the rest of the world too. The world economy is running at half capacity right now. And that's not just China. Airlines and cruise ships gotta be taking a bigger hit. I'm sure the rates for vacations are super low right now. If China's economy goes down, it will have a cascading effect on the global economy. China's skyrocketing debt and absolutely massive housing bubble, along with an already slowing economy, and an aging population, will also be factors. The world economy is collapsing in every country. China is not only a big exporter but also a huge consumer market. It is ASEAN's largest trading partner. China buys a lot of fruit, grain, rubber, etc. from Southeast Asia. If its economy going down, no one can escape. And not just ASEAN. China is the largest trading partner for most of the world's countries. The tourism industry is feeling the first hit. Forced leaves are massive. The dramatic increases in Chinese tourism to Japan the last few years played a pivotal role in preventing a complete Japanese economic freefall. Hence why the Japanese government banned overt racism against Chinese a few years ago. European brand luxury items' largest market is in China. Even for the US, the most significant international consumer of American brands is China. That's why US rhetoric, when it comes to the trade war, is so self-conflicting. The US needs China's economy to continue growing. The problem is that rather than buying more US products, China's turning to its domestic products instead. China is the world economic engine. If it is not China, the whole world economy would already enter the regression phase. Dow Jones has just slid 1,000 points. What does coronavirus mean for the US economy? So, a virus that's 6 times as contagious and 30 times as lethal as the standard flu. Which flattened the world's largest manufacturer in 1 month. And which is just getting started in other countries around the world, which cannot or will not implement the harsh, draconian quarantine that China has, is not enough to cause a collapse? What happens when this hits India, Africa, and North and South America? Millions dead, economies in ruin. China is still in the midst of this and has to force the workers to go back to work, or the economy will collapse. Do you think the United States is going to lock 50 million people in their houses as China did? A study performed by the Los Alamos National Laboratory, which was funded by DARPA to study this virus, concluded that unless a quarantine that is 95% successful is instituted, the virus is unstoppable. If this continues, China is not going to recover, not in this century anyway. Every country will suffer from the coronavirus, not just the economy. South Korea is hit hard, and so is Japan. The weak-ass government in two countries failed to do anything to stop the spread. They are worse comparing to China. Italy is acting now, but it was way too late. Outbreak already spreads to Germany and France. The US currently is refusing to test for COVID-19. Less than 500 are tested. Then guess what happened? Multiple cases of community spread happened. Those are the cases that we cannot trace their origin. Meaning Corona has already arrived in the US and has taken its root. The US government and CDC are just pretending everything is okay by avoiding to test the people for Corona. Because of globalization, everybody's screwed. The economic downturn for the whole world, not just China. The most serious economic impact will affect the transport sector. Tourism spending will suffer severe and permanent loss. The closure of trips to China will affect GDP growth in the first quarter as the authorities quickly moved to full mobilization with control measures applied down to the village level. The big question is, how long will the current control measures remain in effect? The coronavirus epidemic has also led to a decrease in property sales. Much of the real estate and construction activity ends in January and February during normal years. Although the extended Chinese New Year holidays are now over, property transactions will not rebound quickly. The volume of property sales in the first quarter should, therefore, drop by 20-30% year-on-year. The loss of turnover strikes promoters who are already facing a sharp compression of available financing. Regulators have limited fundraising through parallel financing and the sale of bonds. All this means that construction activity will take longer to recover after the shock of the first quarter. Large companies can bypass disruptions in the technology supply chain. Large factories do not know if parts will arrive in time for assembly. Small businesses, on the other hand, may have to delay the launch of new products. The biggest obstacle at the moment is getting workers back. Almost 80% of the manufacturers surveyed do not have enough staff to return to full production. Apple is expected to launch its new iPhone again in the fourth quarter. No country can yet match the advantages of China as a manufacturing base, but it is becoming clear among China's large customers that they will have to increase the geographic diversification of their supplies. What's coming is depression, not recession. A week ago, all the economic indicators nosedived. So no surprise when the market went south 3,500 points and once Trump runs out of QE dollars, there's nothing to stop the market from continuing down in a shower of bankruptcy and unemployment and finally a long deep depression. The current Great Depression now coming down will never end. This is the beginning of the end of the USA as we knew it. Possibly breaking into civil war then collapse of the 48 into several sovereign weak nations. I suggest stocking up on survival items. Too many Americans will not see a doctor due to cost and fear. The Fed will try print money to fix this. It won't make sense, but they will say it's a must. Now finally, I think I know what will cause the next recession. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, subscribe. And please take some time to subscribe to my two backup channels, I do upload videos there too on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. Thank you.